Blackstone Audio presents Cries of the Lost by Chris Knopf. This book is read by Donald Corren. Chapter 1. The tropical sun hung hugely over Grand Cayman Island. We were inadequately shaded by a wind-rustled palm tree overhead. We sat in our rented Suzuki Swift in a remote corner of a parking lot that served the First Australia Bank. The car was small enough to nearly hide below a trimmed hedge. I had a foolish urge to crouch down in my seat. "What could go wrong?" I asked.
"Is that a rhetorical question?" Natsumi asked back.
"Sort of, though I'd like your opinion."
"Nothing, and everything."
"Talk about rhetorical."
"Philosophical. Remember, I'm a child of the East."
"We don't have to do this," I said.
"You're right. We could leave the safe deposit box where it is and never learn what's inside."
"What's the likelihood of that?"
"For you, less than zero." "Was there ever a more curious person?"
"Or paranoid," I said.
I'd recently discovered that my late Chilean wife, Florencia, had a secret bank account at First Australia in Georgetown, the capital of the Cayman Islands, swollen with money and unanswered questions. Armed with the proper codes, IDs, and verifications, and without leaving my computer in America, I'd been able to scoop out and secure most of the liquid assets. Not so with the damn box. They wanted me there when it was opened. I understood why, but handling transactions in person was counter to proper clandestine behavior. Behavior that had thus far kept me and Natsumi Fitzgerald alive, out of jail, and fully operational.
"Fair enough," said Natsumi. "Which is why we're still debating this and not zooming forward like we normally do."
"Sometimes we debate as we zoom."
"I'm not used to seeing you conflicted, Arthur. It's not that endearing."
It was good she couldn't hear all the conflict raging in my head, perceptive woman though she was. The decision to stop off in the Caymans on the way to Chile, where most of the withdrawals from Florencia's secret account had been routed, probably seemed last minute to her, but I'd been chewing on the idea the whole time we'd been in New York preparing for the trip. While thoroughly absorbed in securing false passports and driver's licenses, opening bank accounts in strategic places around the world, setting up international phone coverage and web access, and winnowing electronic gear, clothes, and other essentials down to single carry-on bags, there was always room in my brain for a little obsessive deliberation. To be fair to myself, having learned that my wife had a secret offshore account, stuffed with millions of dollars, the safe deposit box seemed inconsequential at the time. It was only when I tried to extract the contents and was refused that my hyper-curiosity kicked into gear.
"How did Florencia get whatever's in there in the first place?" asked Natsumi. "You said she rarely traveled."
"You can send the bank anything you want and they'll stick it in a box. It's the getting out part that's hard. You gotta be there in person."
"We're wearing disguises, does that help?"
It amazed me how easy it was to change your appearance with simple, off-the-shelf theatrical cosmetics. It just took patience and decent hand skills, which Natsumi had in abundance. Yet I never trusted it. Maybe to fool third-grade mobsters and private citizens, even regular cops. But I held us to higher standards. The hunted could only survive by outwitting the best of the hunters.
"It does," I said,
"though I like you better as a girl." She pulled aside the rearview mirror to check her handiwork.
"I thought it was easier to change gender than race. The sport coat isn't the best choice for the climate, but I needed something baggy."
I cleverly chose a black wig, mustache, and some basic prosthetic enlargement of my nose. Not a small thing to begin with, now a commanding presence.
"So what's the plan?" she asked.
"We walk in and ask for the safe deposit manager. He, or she, takes down all the account information, pulls the file, and asks for the passport and driver's license of the person whose name is attached to the account. This is verified by the account manager within the bank who will accompany us. Assuming everything's in order, we're taken into the vault and given access to the box."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.